So another win at the weekend, another clean sheet. Are you in a happier place now? Do you feel like you've eventually turned a corner?
Yeah, it's definitely felt much better over the last week, getting involved in that with the team and stuff. So it's on a personal note, it's a lot. I feel a lot better now, but on a team level as well, it's been brilliant to get two good results and get closer to where we want to be.
And what do you think the reasons are behind that?
It was just a bit of bad luck coming up to the games. It was getting late own goals, unfortunately, equalises at Morton and stuff like that. Things just had to turn around, and it was just a matter of when and how it was going to happen. And hopefully now with two good results over the last week, hopefully we can go on a little run and get what we want to do.
And does that bolster you? You know, if you do have negative results, you go sort of on a downhill slope. This is the other way around now.
Yeah, it cripples the confidence quite a lot, not getting as many wins as we wanted and picking up draws, getting losses as well as we did, and just overall the way things have been around the training ground, it just deflates everyone's, the atmosphere has just not been the best. But you know, this place has been a different place now last week after St Mirren game, and that it lifted us definitely for the Falkirk game.
And what are your thoughts ahead of the game at Brechin?
It's a difficult one. No game is going to ever be easy. It's a bit of a banana skin game, you know, people expecting us to win, but no disrespect to Brechin or that, but it's 100% going to be a hard game. Still, doesn't matter where they are at the league table, they're a respected club in the league still.
You sort of touched on the banana skin game, obviously everything to play for. Do you think it's more important than ever that you don't take your eye off the ball?
100%, this is going to be in some ways a bigger game than it was to play Brechin on St Mirren, Tuesday night, and then Falkirk on the weekend. This Brechin game tomorrow night is the biggest one that we're going to come across. We've got to not keep our foot on the pedal and keep going.
And something that the manager's always keen to hammer home is that you just need to take each game as it comes. Is that something you'd agree with?
100%. We can't look too far ahead and get carried away with ourselves. We've just got to take each game as it comes and approach every game like that.
Do you still have quite a strong belief that you can catch up with Livingston?
100%. It's difficult. It's not out of the realms of possibility, but we're fully aware that we've got to get good results from now to the end of the season and keep on going the way that we have.
And how confident are you that you're going to be able to do that?
We have to be confident. It's been difficult, like I said, the confidence has been low, but the last couple of results have definitely picked it up, so we've got to be confident going into these games and believe in ourselves.
I was going to ask you, Dennis, how important is it after two wins in a row, two shutouts in a row, that you maintain the momentum now?
It's very important. Defensively, I think we've been solid. Two great starts to the game, which we haven't been having. So that's been a positive as well, to actually start the game on the front foot and capitalise on that as well. So it's definitely big to try and keep going the way that we have. And like the gaffer said, if we carry on getting 1-0 wins, he's more than happy with it, and I'm sure everyone else is as well.
How pleased are you with your own form? You've come in for the last couple of games, two shutouts. That must be great for a goalkeeper's confidence.
Yeah, it's helped massively as well, coming into the team and that, and starting to get games and that. But like I said, the team has been great and stuff, and it's been they've helped out massively, and it's no credit away from them whatsoever. I've had minimal to do so.
How much of an added incentive is it when you look ahead to tomorrow's game? If you get a victory, you do move to within 1 point of second place. Is that an added incentive, or do you just think, let's just go out and win the game?
It's definitely an incentive to try and catch up with Livingston, 100%. But like I said earlier as well, and the gaffer said, we're taking it one game at a time and just get as many points from now to the end of the season as we can and finish as high as we can.
The approach from the team over the last couple of games certainly seems to have been different than it has over the last week. What do you think helped raise that?
I think we've understood now and appreciated the fact that, you know, we have to turn it around now, and it's not a time for starting the way that we have been in that, and it's grabbing the games by the scruff of the neck and just going at it and trying to get results that we've not been getting, and having a good go at it from start to finish, which I think the boys have been.
The fact that St Mirren could have won the league at Tannadice last week, did that have any bearing on the team's sort of look at things?
It did. It was a bit of a wake-up call, I think, for all of us to for the manner that St Mirren could come to Tannadice, get a point at our home ground and take the league, it would have hurt us massively and crippled us in some ways. So I think we got together and we said, look, no matter what happens, these lot don't walk out of the door with that trophy in their hands, and we just make them wait as long as it's possible. And we did, fortunately enough, it was a good game and we managed to help make them wait.
The trip to Beacon tomorrow will be very different from the last two games that you've had. I mean, you've played at Tannadice for the last two games with a good home crowd behind and a perfect playing surface from there. The manager spoke about having to have tunnel vision when you go away to Beacon to keep that same level going. Is that something that you would agree with?
Definitely. You know, it's different surrounds and stuff. It's an away game, like you said, so we've got to understand that there's going to be more fans probably from them that there would be at Tannadice. So it's just shutting it out, but I'm pretty sure we're going to have a good backing because it's only 20, 30 minutes down the road and we usually take a very good crowd with us to Brechin.
And from a team point of view, do you think you'll be able to maintain that high sort of level of anticipation that's been there for the last two games to keep these performances going?
I'm hoping so. I'm hoping that we're going to go out and give it a good go again tomorrow. So hopefully it's right on the night.
Can I just get your thoughts on the news we heard about James Keating's earlier today? His dad was involved in an accident on holiday abroad. I'm sure the thoughts of all the lads are with James and his family.
Yes, yeah, it's a tough situation to have, but you know, I'm sure we're all going to be behind James and that, and give him the support he needs from us. And it's a horrible situation, but we're all going to be there for him and be behind his back and help get through him as much as we can.